So in continuation of the cell constituents, we are going to discuss about the glycosides. In last class, we discussed about the alkaloids. So glycosides are also the organic compounds which are there as a excretory products into the plants. They are biosynthesizing into the plants, and they will be having some medicinal values also that can be used for the different therapeutic purpose, right? So glycosides, it is very common and well-known compound obtained from the plants. So we are going to discuss about how the glycosides, they are occurring into the plants, and what are the different identification tests, what are the examples of the plant which will contain the glycosides, right? So let us discuss one by one. Natural compounds present in a lot of plants and some animals also. These compounds upon hydrolysis gives one or more sugar moiety, right? So the sugar moiety, it is known as glycone, and the non-sugar moiety also it giving, that is the aglycone or called genein, right? So upon hydrolysis, remember these things, no one constituent will go under hydrolysis. Upon hydrolysis, it will yield into two constituents, one sugar moiety, one non-sugar moiety. Sugar moiety is called a glycone, non-sugar moiety is called a glycone. So in this only everything go on in glycosides. So generally, what are the other things under glycosides more important in medicine than a lot of drug? It occur in higher plant tissues in very small amount. Also fungal and bacterial cells also they are in, and some animals also it is present. Formed by the biochemical reactions that makes a water insoluble compound more polar than the water soluble molecule. And man forms them in the liver also as a part of the process of detoxification, right? Glycosides also forms in the liver, okay? And they are excreted by or via urine, right? Mammalian glycosides are simple compounds, whereas the plant glycosides are much larger and chemically more complex. That is the difference between the mammalian and plant. So glycosides are natural substances that contain carbohydrates, where glycosidic parts of a molecule, that is cyclic form of a sugar, is connected with an organic radical, that is not a sugar or a glycone or genein. Right, that's our sugar and non-sugar moiety. We have seen in the definition. Okay, so they will be connected. That's what the glycone and aglycone part, they will be connected with each other, right? By the nature of the sugar, glycosides are divided into two groups, like pyrenoids, pyrenocytes, and furanocytes. There are also and glycosides defined depending on the configuration of carbon connected to the aglycone. Sugar part of the molecule may contain one or more interconnected sugars like monosaccharides, disaccharides, trisaccharides, and so on. Pentosides, pentose glycosides, hexosides, hexose glycosides, biocides, glycosides, and disaccharides. So like that, it will go on, right? So coming to the physicochemical properties of glycosides, so let us understand what are the property it will have. Generally, these are colorless, solid, amorphous, non-volatile. Like where the flavonoids are also comes under the glycosides only. The flavonoids, yellow color, generally yellow color. And anthraquinone glycosides, they are red or orange. So these are the exceptional case under glycoside. That's what. The color also mentioned, flavonoid, yellow color means flavonoid generally, and anthraquinone red or orange. It gives positive reaction with mollish and failing solution test after hydrolysis, remember, right? Generally, mollish and failing solution test is for carbohydrates, and we have seen that there are saccharides also, sugar moiety. So after hydrolysis, it will yield into the sugar and non-sugar moiety. So whatever sugar moiety it is there, that will give the positive test for the mollish and failing solution test. They are water soluble compounds, but insoluble in organic solvents. Most of them have bitter taste, except exceptional case always you should remember, except populine and glycyrrhizine and steviocyte. Right, these three are the exceptional. those will not be having bitter taste generally, and most of them will be having the bitter taste. Odorless except saponin, like glycyrrhizine. Glycyrrhizine, it is odd. It will be having odor, right? Except this thing, right? When a glycoside has a lot of sugars, its solubility in water decreases, right? Even sugar will be more, solubility will be less in water. Okay, glycoside hydrolyzed by using mineral acid and a temperature or by enzymes, right? So that's what we have in our definition. Under enzymatic or acid hydrolysis, glycosides yield in the sugar and non-sugar moiety. That's what we have seen in the definition of glycosides. Glycosides are water-soluble compounds and insoluble in organic solvents, right? So the glycone part, it is water-soluble, but insoluble in organic solvent, right? Whereas a glycone part, which is non-sugar moiety, water insoluble and soluble in organic solvent. Some glycosides soluble in alcohol also. Role of glycosides in plants. Converting toxic materials to non or less toxic. It transfer water insoluble substances by using monosaccharide. Source of energy, like these are the sugar reservoir. Storing harmful products such as phenol. Regulation of certain functions like growth of the plant. Some have beautiful colors. That's what they are participating in pollination process. Because of the beautiful color, they will attract the insects or other flies. Dragonfly and this thing, and it will go for pollen. Some glycosides have antibacterial activity, so they protect the plant from bacteria and other types of disease which can be attacking to the different plants. Coming to the glycoside classification, classification of glycoside on the basis of linkage between the glycon and a glycone part. O glycosides, O, right? These glycosides, the sugar part is linked with oxygen atom. O is for oxygen atom of a glycone part. S glycosides, this is sulfur glycosides. In this glycoside, the sugar attached to the sulfur atom of a glycone. Example, sinigrin. N glycosides, nitrogen. In this glycoside, the sugar linked with the nitrogen atom of amino group of a glycone. For example, nucleosides, DNA, RNA. C glycosides. In these glycosides, the sugar linked or directly to the carbon atom of a glycone. For example, alloyne. So here as the atom where it is linking, that's what it is categorized. Classification glycosides based on glycone part. Like glucose. Example, cenoside. Rhamnose, the frangulin, digoxin, glucose and rhamnose, glucoramnosides like glucofuran and gluni, rhamnose and glucose, rhamnoglucosides and rutin. So here, glycone part, it is how? The glycone part, it is glucose, rhamnose, dextrose, glucose, rhamnose, what? And these are the examples which we need to write compulsory. Another mode of classification of glycosides based on chemical group. What group of chemical they belong? Like example, for example, saponins, soap-like structure, a glycon, like trans-linked steroids, ginseng, Dioscorea, in that way. Okay. Coming to the second one, cardiac glycosides means poison, right? From squill and digitalis. So as the name indicate, cardiac glycosides, they are going to have the contraction and relaxation muscles of the cardiac muscles, right? So that's what anthraquinone derivative or anthracene derivatives, purgative, like aloe, senna, cascara, like flavonoidal, mainly anti-inflammatory drugs like ginkgo, then buckwheat, coumarin, cyclooxygenase inhibitors like ammi and visanga, phenolic analgesics like aspirin, and cyanogenetic compounds like bitter almond, wild cherry, black, right? So these are the different mode. Here another mode, classification of glycoside based on their therapeutic effects, right? How, what is the pharmacological action? What is the therapeutic value of that particular? So you can see CHF, congestive heart failure, and cardiac muscles stimulators. That's what. In cardiac glycosides also we have seen in the chemical based digitalis leaf or digitalis glycosides. From digitalis leaf, what are the chemical constituents we can get? Digoxin, digitoxin, and gitoxin. Foxglove leaves or digitalis leaf. Foxglove is also known as digitalis. Okay, here that's what digitalis glycosides. Then uabine. Examples here, Estropanthus gratus seed, Estropanthus seed or Estropanthus plant, whatever the fruit seed we are getting, it will be having these types of glycoside which are having the effect on cardiac muscle. K-estropanthin, this is the one of the chemical constituents from Estropanthus comb seeds or Estropanthus seeds also you can say, right? Then Silarion A and B, which isolated from the red and white squill bulb. Squill is the one of the medicinal plant. From that bulbs we are taking as a part of the this thing, and we are getting the Silarine A and B, which is having activity on cardiac muscles. Laxative group of glycosides, the glycoside which are having laxative effects, sinusoid A, B, C, and D, obtained from senna leaves and fruits also. Cascarocytes A, B, obtained from cascara bark. Aloin and barboloin, aloe vera and aloe barbadensis juice. Okay, local irritant group like fenugreek, black mustard seeds, and Brassica nigra, that is called. Okay, analgesic and antipyretics, then salicin and salicylic acid, the willow and salix bark, anti-inflammatory groups, aloin for acne, glycyrrhizin for peptic ulcer. So these are the different medicinal value. When it comes to the extraction of glycosides, how we are going to extract, there are three steps has been given. Drying of the plant fresh in special oven at 100 degree centigrade for the 30 minutes. Okay. Step two, boiling them with organic solvents for 20 minutes. That also we can perform. And step three, boiling them with the acetone for 5 minutes. If present in this plant tannin or resins, we add lead acetate to precipitate this tannin and resin, right? So deactivation of enzyme, that is very important in step one. So here what we are doing, drying off 15 to 30 minutes at 100 degree centigrade, followed by slow drying at low temperature. Dipping the fresh material into boiling water or boiling alcohol for 10 to 20 minutes. Boiling the fresh plant material with acetone. Carrying out the extraction at low, very low temperature. Freeze drying of the plant material before extraction, that is called a lyophilization. Then carrying the extraction in the presence of sodium bisulfite. Second step, maintenance of neutral condition. That's also very important during the process. Neutral pH should be assured by before and during extraction, because acidity may result in hydrolysis. This is overcome by addition of calcium carbonate. Mild alkalinity may sometimes produce racemization. That's also very problem. Defatting of fat-rich organs like seeds, estropancer seeds, and all those things before extraction. That also we need to do. High amount of lipoids hinder glycosides extraction. Here, defatting is usually carried out by the petroleum ether. We have to do. We are doing with the petroleum ether only. In other plants also, defatting will be done by the, like that. Solvent and the solvent partition. Here, water and water or hexane or chloroform to remove pigment in the non-polar phase. Adsorption methods. Here, adsorbents like silite, Fuller's earth, and graphite. Chromatography. Precipitate out impurities. Crystallization. That is the final stage. Like, okay. So, in that way, we are going to do here. Okay, when it comes to the chemical identification or how we are going to perform chemical test or identification test to confirm that the given sample of extract or plant material, it is having glycosides or not. So here Lieberman's test, right? Lieberman-Burchard test. What we have to do in this 2 ml of extract, whatever the extract we have extracted in previous slides, that extract 2 ml you have to take. And add 2 ml of chloroform, CHCl3, and 2 ml of carboxylic acids here, right, violet to blue to green coloration. Anthraquinone border trigger test, 3 ml extract, 3 ml benzene, 5 ml of ammonia, 10%, pink, violet, or red coloration in ammonical layer. Coumarin glycoside, if it is, 2 ml extract and 3 ml of sodium hydroxide, 10%, yellow coloration. Saponin foam test, here 5 ml extract to 5 ml water and heat, fourth will form. And 5 ml extract olive oil, if you'll add few drop, emulsion will form. So these are the confirmation tests which we can do when it comes to the glycosides sample. Okay, so further we can study for the glycosides. Thank you.